What is going on, everybody? My name is Alex Freeberg, and today we're going to be looking at data analyst interview questions. For the most part, we're really just going to be looking at SQL interview questions, but if you want me to make a Python interview questions video in the future, I can be sure to do that. Now, we're going to be going through a lot of information and a ton of questions today. Every single question that you see here is going to be on my GitHub with all the answers below it. So if I don't cover that exact question in this video, you can check it out and I will have the answer on my GitHub. The link is in the description if you want to read that later. So with that being said, let's get into it. So now let's look at some phone interview questions. And for the most part, you're just going to be asked broad generic questions just to gauge your abilities on a few different subjects. And then when you get to the in-person interview, they'll ask a little bit more technical questions. And we'll get to the in-person interview stuff in just a little bit. But now let's look at a few questions for the phone interview stage. So a few questions that they might ask you are things like, on a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate your SQL abilities? Can you describe or how do you currently use SQL? And have you ever used a cloud-based platform? Now, these are kind of the more technical questions or broad technical questions that they may ask you. And these give you an opportunity just to talk a little bit about what you know and how you've used SQL in the past. So for me, I might say that I'm an 8 out of 10 in SQL, and I currently use it to query tables and views, as well as create reports and automate stored procedures to send out those reports to clients on a weekly or monthly basis. And for the cloud-based platform, I might say that I've used Amazon Web Services as well as Azure. And in Azure, I use Azure Data Lake as well as Databricks. And I'm mostly using that for data acquisition and data augmentation. So like I said, those are the more technical questions that I think they may ask you. There are some more broad questions that they may ask as well. Something like, what was your most challenging data analyst project? Describe a time when you had to work with a group on a data analyst project. Are you familiar with any cloud platforms? And describe a time when you've made a mistake on a project and how you handled it. So for that last one, I might say something like this. I was working directly with a client to do some analysis on some 2019 data for a deliverable that they have. And at the time, we had two separate servers. One server had old historical data and another server had new updated data. And in those servers, they basically had all the same databases and the same tables. And so when I was doing my analysis, I accidentally used the old server instead of the new server. When I sent my analysis over to the client, they noted that the numbers looked a little bit off, and I quickly retraced my steps and figured out that I'd been using the wrong server with the wrong database and the wrong table the whole time. When I figured out the mistake, I let them know as soon as I could and that I'd get them a new analysis as quickly as I could. Luckily, I had a really good rapport with the client, and he said it was totally fine just to get him a new analysis of the correct data as quickly as I could. I had actually sent him the wrong analysis about 3 days before our deadline, so I had 3 extra days to get him the new analysis, so I was able to meet the deadline in the end. That was definitely a mistake on my part. I just wasn't thinking, I made a mistake, and I made sure to never do that again. Something to remember is that when you're answering any of these questions, you want to make yourself look as good as possible. So even though I'm talking about how I made a mistake, I made sure to talk about how I had really good rapport with the client, how I notified the client right away, and how I got him a new analysis before the deadline was even up. So even though we're talking about me making a mistake, I made sure to highlight some of the things that make me look good or some of the things that the interviewers might want to hear. So now let's look at some in-person interview questions. Now, the phone interview questions were kind of broad and generic, and the in-person interview questions are a little bit more specific and a little bit more technical. Let's look at some beginner questions, and then we'll move on to some intermediate questions that you might be asked. So for the beginner questions, there are questions like, what is the difference between a table and a view? How would you write a query that would remove duplicate records? I have 2 columns called drug name and drug price. Each drug has different prices depending on where it is being sold. I want to see the drug name with the highest price it is being sold at. How would you write that query? Now I'm actually going to stop and show you the answer to this question. If you want to pause it and you want to try to get the answer correct before we look at the answer, go for it. If not, we're going to look at it right now. So here is the answer. Let's briefly go through the question again and then look at the answer. So you have 2 columns, drug name and drug price, and each drug has different prices depending on where it's being sold. So that means there could be drug aspirin, 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 and 3 different prices, and we want to get the price that is the highest. And so I want to see the drug name with the highest price is being sold at. How would you write that query? So we're going to do select drug name, comma, max, which is an aggregate function, which is going to give us the highest or the largest number of drug price. And then we're going to do from table and then group by drug name. And we have to do the group by because we're using an aggregate function in the select statement. And then we're just ordering it by the drug name. And that will give us the output that we are looking for. On to number 4, what does the group by statement do in a query and why would you use it? And then number 5 is I have a column called drug name. I want to look at drugs that start with aspirin. How would you only return drug names that start with aspirin? And then the answer for that one is use the like operator. So you'll do like aspirin and then have a wildcard after that. And that's the answer to that one. So now let's move on to some intermediate questions. They're going to be a little bit more difficult, a little bit more challenging than the beginner questions. I think the beginner questions are more geared towards entry-level data analysts, where the intermediate might be a little bit more difficult or for a higher level position. But you never know, they might be asking really difficult questions for that entry-level job. You know, I don't know. So let's look at these intermediate questions really quick. So the first one is, what is a subquery? And can you describe how you would write that? What is a join and what data would be returned if you use an inner join? What is the difference between an inner and outer join? What is a case statement and how would you use it? What is a union operator and how would you use it? And then for number six is, I have two tables. One table contains patient information and the other contains drug information. In the patient table, we have a patient ID, first name, last name, and disease. In the drug table, we have patient ID, dispensed drug, date dispensed. Can you create a query to return patient ID, disease, and dispensed drug? So now let's look at the answers to number two and number six. Again, if you want to try to solve these before you look at them, that's totally fine, but we will look at the answers right now. So for question number two, it said, what is a join and what data would be returned if you use an inner join? And the answer might be something like this. A join combines two tables into a single output. An inner join will return data that intersects or is common between both tables. And for example, if table one has ABC and table two has B and C, only B and C will be returned because A is only in table one. So that is what a join is, and that is what an inner join would return. So now let's look at number six. It says, I have two tables. One table contains patient information and the other drug information. In the patient table, we have ID, first name, last name, disease. In the drug table, we have patient ID, dispensed drug, date dispensed. All you want to do is combine these tables and have patient ID, disease, and dispensed drug. So in order to do that, you're just gonna do an inner join. So the answer is select patient.patientID. We have to do patient dot because we have to specify what table it is, because patient ID is in both the patient and the drug table. Comma disease, comma dispensed drug from the patient table. And we're gonna join the drug table on patient.patientID is equal to drug.patientID. These are more technical interview questions. You may get other questions like, tell me about yourself, or questions that you might get in any interview for any job. I wanted to be more specific and intentional about doing data analyst specific questions and not just general questions that you'll get anywhere. Remember, if you want the answers to any of these questions, I will have all the questions and the answers on my GitHub. The link is in the description. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you like this video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe below, and I'll see you in the next video.